I think after Saturday, you guys will have three home games, so essentially four home games left in a tight race. Have you guys gotten together all as a team to kind of talk about maybe the way you need to finish or kind of what needs to happen moving forward?
Man, we just need to win home games because it's like the main aspect of every year. You got to take care of business at home, and then on the road, we got to win like every possible game. But like, we cannot lose at home. But like, this year, it's kind of the opposite. We lost like one game on the road, and lost more at home. So we just got to figure out how to play at home better than on the road.
Coach says there's a smaller margin of error this season. Why is that?
Well, because the league is so good. And right now, I think Austin, Texas Tech is tied for first, and we just don't have, we cannot make errors anymore. And we just got to win every game and you know, be focused every time and play with the energy of the day.
How much do you guys find yourself watching other games on TV when either before a game or after a game when y'all aren't playing around the league? How much do you guys sit around and watch the other teams in the league?
Every time we hit, like, every time a team plays, we have time. But most of the time, it's just like us and some other teams play at the same time. But like, if we have a chance, we always wish us to play.
Coach Self said that if everybody on the team tried as hard as you and Devontae do, that the team would be much better off. What's your reaction to that statement that he said on Saturday?
I would say we just try harder than we did, and if we try hard, we're definitely gonna make a mistake, but we're just gonna make up for them later. But we play without energy, we're kind of slow, and you play with energy, it's hard to keep.
What leads to playing without energy? Is it just a lack of effort, or maybe just not being prepared?
I don't know.
Devontae ranks second in the Big 12 in assists, and whether he's on the team or the league, what makes him such a good passer of the ball?
He's a really good ball handler, and he's a good guy. Everybody trying to help, because if they don't help, he's going to make a layup, and then out of there, he passes the ball really good, and he's going to make
a shot. Can you talk about the lob dunks you're getting now, getting to the hoop, and you're showing more athleticism? Is that just because of confidence in what you're able to do?
I would say just me and Jerry again about lobs. You gotta be aware, but sometimes like you people see Jerry in the corner and expect the lob and be busy, but they don't really expect that. So we just kind of change it up sometimes. But just trying to be aggressive all the time, drive the ball more because everybody expects me to shoot and everybody goes down a little harder than me every time. So I just figure out other ways to score.
Is there effects of Coach Hootie? I mean, can you jump higher now as a senior?
I just never jumped before, like in games, so I just trying to be more athletic right now. I'm just trying to show it a little bit more.
You've had some threes that you passed up and driven and gotten dunks and tried to get layups. And has that been something that you would have done when you were younger, or is that something that you're making a specific effort to try to show that's part of your game this year?
Yes, and like I was saying, like, everybody knows about the shoot, so like everybody trying to round me up the 3-point line and trying to close out a little harder so it's open up. Like, I would rather take open two than like third or three.
So this time around against TCU, like, they're without their point guard. How will you attack the Horned Frogs? Because it'll be a different looking team than what you played up in Fort Worth.
They're really good. Basically, Robinson, the point guard, he's a great passer. He hurt us really bad previous games. And, they still have players. And, if they lost one player, the team beat West Virginia at home. And, it might just help them because they will have a tighter huddle and they're going to try harder because they know they short for one player, including two player. And, it might help.
Can you explain why you guys are playing better on the road?
I feel like I would say we play harder on the road because we know there's no fans around. And, it's fans around, but opposite team, and we just try it really hard because, you know, it's just us over there, and we just believe in ourselves.
Are you glad your next one's at home after what happened Saturday?
Yeah, definitely, because we just need to get paid back, and we need to recover from the last game, and we're just trying to show the fans that we can play at home way better than the last previous game. It was really a mistake, and never gonna happen again.
Do you think the younger guys get what it takes to play here and to play in front of fans and to make this the atmosphere that it's been throughout your career? I mean, pretty far in the season.
But. Yeah, I would say they're learning during the season, but as for me, I never knew about camps when I got here before, so I think I didn't really know how good this place before I got here, but like during my career, like my freshman summer, I've been learning really a lot about this place, how big a tradition it is, and how much this place means to other people, how much this program means to other people, so I think they're learning during the season.
Speed, the last Saturday game was early. Were you able to have the 5 strawberries for good luck?
Yeah, definitely. We always have food before games. So I mean, yeah, that's strawberries.
Where do you eat them?
Just on my way. I have them by hand.
Do you bring them from your dorm?
Nah, from the locker room.
Oh. Yeah. All right, Speed.
Thanks, Speed.